Assalamu alaikum. This is the macroeconomics course directed to second year, groups A, C, D, M, and R. Let's continue the national income and the price level in the long run. This lecture will cover the following points. First, the long run effects of aggregate demand shocks. Second, the long run effects of SRAS shocks. Third, what is meant by the long-run aggregate supply curve, how to drive this curve, and what's meant by this curve. In the last, we will take the paradox of thrift, what's meant by paradox of thrift. First, let's start by the long-run effects of aggregate demand shocks. We have two types of shocks, either expansionary aggregate demand shocks. We can call it demand shock inflation. Second, we have contractionary aggregate demand shocks. We can call it negative aggregate demand shocks. We can call it demand shock deflation. هنا عندي two types of aggregate demand shocks. إما طبعا ده معناه إن the aggregate demand curve will shift either rightward, وبنقول على الشوك ديت expansionary shock أو positive aggregate demand shocks. تمام؟ لازم نكونوا فاهمين the factors that affect the aggregate demand. Aggregate demand could shift rightward when autonomous expenditures increase. Either autonomous consumption, autonomous investment, government expenditures. We have other factors that could affect aggregate demand, which is money supply. بس consider في الجزء ده اللي احنا بنتكلم على الـ tools of fiscal policy اللي ممكن نتيجة لزيادة الـ government expenditures or ان taxes قلت other factors could affect aggregate demand curve and cause rightward shift in aggregate demand curve. ده بسميه expansionary aggregate demand shock or positive aggregate demand shock. ممكن نقول عليها برضو demand shock inflation. On the other side, لما بيكون عندي negative aggregate demand shocks, جت من فين؟ لو كان عندي decrease in autonomous expenditures like investment, government expenditures, the wealth decrease, or we have an increase in taxes. We call this negative or contractionary aggregate demand shocks. في برضو مسمى تاني بنسميه demand shock deflation. Okay, هنبتدي بالexpansionary aggregate demand shocks. أنا دلوقتي عايز أعرف نقطة البداية إيه؟ إن أنا ببتدي starting at a point where there is no gap. تمام؟ إيه اللي يحصل؟ لو أنا ابتديت بposition ما عنديش gap inside the economy, the actual level of output equals the potential level of output, وبعدين حصل expansionary aggregate demand shocks. طبعا في الحالة دي هيبقى open a gap. ممكن تكون الجاب ديت هنعرف هل هي inflationary gap أو recessionary gap. How to remove this gap. الهدف من الجزء ده اللي أنا عايز أعرف ال effect of expansionary aggregate demand shocks على ال level of output وال prices. تمام؟ هنبتدي في الأول starting from the point E note. تمام؟ the intersection between SRAS note and aggregate demand note. في البداية خالص the economy experience no gap. The actual level of output equal the potential level of output at E note. ده نقطة البداية عندي. Now suppose that there is increase in aggregate demand. ممكن نقول عليها increase in aggregate demand due to increase in investment, increase in government expenditures. نفس معنى لو أنا عندي expansionary fiscal policy. لو الـ government adopt an expansionary fiscal policy. هيحصل إيه؟ الـ aggregate demand curve will shift rightward from aggregate demand note to aggregate demand 1. The new equilibrium would be E1. اللي بيحصل؟ أنا اتحركت من point E note لـ E1. الكلام ده حصل إمتى؟ حصل في الـ short run. تمام؟ the actual level of output is greater than the potential level of output. يبقى أنا كده عندي inflationary gap. Okay. طيب, what would happen when we have inflationary gap? How could this gap would be eliminated? لازم أبقى فاهم, طالما أنا أنتجت أكتر من البوتنشال, ده معناه أن demand for resources, demand for labor increase, wages increase, معناه أن the cost of production would increase. When the cost of production increases, SRAS would shift upward to the left from SRAS node to SRAS 1, and the gap is closed at a higher price. تمام؟ يبقى الاكسبانشنري اجريجيت ديماند شوكس عندها تو افكت, في افكت على الشورت رن, في افكت في اللونج رن. In the short run we have temporary increase in the level of output or temporary increase in the level of national income. In the long run there is no change in the level of output, there is no change in the level of national income, while there is increase in the price level. Second, بالنسبة للnegative aggregate demand shocks, first of all, we have to remember what are the main causes of these shocks. Aggregate demand could shift leftward when we have a reduction in investment, in government expenditures, or increasing in taxes. Okay, starting point, the point of intersection between aggregate demand curve and SRAS curve, point A note. Now suppose that we have a reduction in investment, or the government adopt contractionary fiscal policy. This would cause aggregate demand curve to shift leftward from aggregate demand node to aggregate demand 1. طبعا أنا ببتدي من point A node where the economy experiences no gap. The Y equal Y star. ما عنديش gap inside the economy. دلوقتي the government decided to adopt fiscal policy, contractionary fiscal policy, by reducing government expenditures or increasing taxes. تمام؟ aggregate demand curve would shift leftward from aggregate demand node to aggregate demand 1. Okay, what would happen in this case? Now the economy is producing below the potential level of output. In this case, we have a recessionary gap. طالما تم إنتاج أقل من الـ potential level of output, ده معناه إن إحنا عندنا unemployment, يعني demand for labor would be low and wages would decrease. In this case, a reduction in wages affects the SRAS curve. Okay, SRAS curve would shift in this case rightward, and the economy would return to the potential level of output in this case, and the gap is removed at a lower price. فالمهم دلوقتي نعرف ان in the long run this negative aggregate demand shock would close the recessionary gap at lower price with no effect on the national income. يبقى تأثير negative aggregate demand shock هي عندها two effect. في effect في short run اللي أنا عندي temporary reduction in the level of output. تمام؟ والtemporary reduction ده هو ده اللي بنسميه recessionary gap. But in the long run we have no effect on the level of output. There is no effect on the level of national income, while there is a reduction in the price level. Now moving to the next point, the long-run effects of SRAS shocks. The target of this point is knowing the impact of either positive shocks or negative shocks on the supply side in the long run, on the level of national income or on the level of output. Starting by positive SRS shocks. طبعا وانا بذاكر لازم اكون عارف ان الشورت ران اجريجيت سبلاي كيرف بيتاثر ب two factors. The whole curve is affected by two factors, productivity and the input prices. Positive shock, it means that we have either enhancement in productivity or reduction in input prices. تمام؟ نفترض ان انا عندي reduction in the oil prices, reduction in wages, or enhancement in productivity, increase in the productivity of factors of production. This would affect short-run aggregate supply curve and goes rightward the shift in the whole curve. تمام؟ نبتدي بpoint E note. It's the starting point عندي هي E note where aggregate demand curve intersect with short-run aggregate supply curve. The economy experiences no gap, fish gap. We are producing at the potential level of output at Y star. تمام؟ بعدين نفترض إن أنا عندي reduction in wages. تمام؟ ده معناه إن cost of production would decrease. In this case, SRES curve would shift rightward from SRES note to SRES 1. We are moving from point A note to A1. This open an inflationary gap. Why? Because the level of output is above the potential level of output. Okay. يبقى the immediate impact of positive SRES shocks is inflationary gap. How could this gap would be eliminated? We know that when Y or the level of output is greater than the potential, it means that the demand for factors of production would increase. عشان the price of factors of production in this case decrease, فالدمand عليهم هيزيد. ولما demand هيزيد, the price of factors of production would increase, and this cause the short run aggregate supply curve to shift again leftward to SRES note, and until this gap would be removed. Okay, and we are returning back to E note. So in the long run, this positive SRES shock would close this inflationary gap with no effect on either price level or the level of national income. Okay, if the gap is removed with no effect on the price level or the level of national income, while in the short run, there is a temporary change in the level of national income. Now turning to the negative SRES shocks, we can call it contractionary shock. Type, what are the main causes of this shock? Either increase in the input prices or deterioration in the productivity of factors of production. Okay, starting at E note, point of equilibrium, ببتدي بنقطة equilibrium, where we have no gap. The economy is producing the potential level of output. Now consider that we have a deterioration in the productivity of factors of production. تمام؟ This would affect SRES curve. The whole curve would moved upward from SRES node to SRES 1. In this case, the level of output is lower than the potential level of output. Okay, these negative SRS shocks opens a recessionary gap. طبعا احنا قلنا ونفتكر ان the negative SRS shocks open حاجة اسمها stagflation. We have a reduction in the level of output and an increase in the price level. So we have inflation and stagnation. We can call it stagflation. Okay, so the short-run impact of negative SRS shocks would be a recessionary gap. We have temporary change in the level of output. تمام؟ recessionary gap معناها ايه؟ معناها ان demand for resources decrease. معناها ان price of factors of production would be lower than before. لما prices of factors of production is decreased, this would cause a rightward shift in SRES curve. فالكيرف هيرجع تاني. طبعا بياخد وقت لحد ما بيرجع والجاب is removed or eliminated in the long run. ففي النهاية أنا برجع تاني للإي نوت where there is no change in the price level and the level of output. يبقى in the long run a negative SRES shocks will close this recessionary gap with no effect on the level of output and the level of the price, but there is a temporary change in the level of output or in the level of national income in the short run. Concerning the third point, the long run aggregate supply curve. First of all, لازم نبقى فاهمين الـ long run aggregate supply curve اللي هو الـ vertical line ده. ده جاي من فين؟ ده عبارة عن إيه؟ This line shows a relationship between the price and the level of output in the long run. تمام؟ ده نتيجة إن أنا عندي adjustment take place to remove any gap. لو رجعنا للpositive and the negative aggregate demand و short run aggregate supply shocks, أنا ببتدي بنقطة الequilibrium اللي هي الـ E note. تمام؟ بيحصل ساعتها مثلا نتيجة للشوكس اللي بتحصل inside the economy whether at the supply side or at the demand side, دي بتعمل opening لجابس either anti-inflationary gap or recessionary gap. بعد كده through the automatic adjustment mechanism الجاب ديت is removed and eliminated, وفي الآخر خالص the economy in the long run بيرجع تاني للpotential level of output. تمام؟ طالما بيرجع تاني معناه ان انا عندي شوية adjustments بتحصل inside the economy in order to remove any gap. في الاخر خالص الـ economy بيستقر عند نقطة تانية بس بينتج الـ Y star. اوكي؟ فالـ long run aggregate supply curve ده vertical line اوكي relates the price level and the level of national income after all adjustments take place inside the economy to remove any gaps. Okay, أنا بستقر في الآخر خالص أنا بوصل النقط نقطة البداية اللي أنا ابتديت بيها in the short run E-note بالنقطة اللي economy بيوصل عندها بعد ما بيعمل removing للgaps whether we have inflationary gap or recessionary gap. بوصل النقطتين دول ببعض بيجي لي vertical line هو long run aggregate supply curve. Okay, طيب هو vertical. ليه هو vertical؟ because the level of output is always constant in the long run. Okay, يعني معناه ان economy is producing the potential level of output. Okay, we can call it classical aggregate supply curve, لكن هو مختلف تماما على vertical shape of SRES curve. Okay, طيب ده معناه ان هو مثلا vertical وانا الايكونومي از برودوسينج ذا بوتنشال ليفل اوف اوتبوت. ده معناه ان هو ما بيتغيرش خالص, يعني ما ينفعش خالص ان هو يعني الايكونومي كود برودوس ا هاير ليفل اوف اوتبوت هاير ذان ذا بوتنشال. لا طبعا ممكن في فاكتورز بنسميها ريل فاكتورز ممكن تحصل عشان كده اللونج ران اجريجيت سبلاي كيرف كود شيفت rightward, either طبعا rightward or leftward. بس نتكلم بس في factors that could affect or increase the long run aggregate supply curve. تمام؟ من ضمن factors ديت لو أنا عندي increase in the efficiency of using factors of production، عندي مثلا إن level of education enhanced، في adopting higher technology. تمام، طبعا الفاكتورز ديت هتعمل ايه؟ برضو عشان نفهم الجراف، انا عند اي نوت، تمام، واقف بنتج عند اي نوت، تمام كده، وبعدين حصل enhancement in technology increasing in factors of production. طبعا ال SRES would shift rightward. okay، and the economy is producing a higher level of potential level of output in the long run. طبعا التحرك من E0 لE1 طبعا takes time. okay، فالفاكتورز that affect long run aggregate supply curve could be technological progress، increase in the supply of labor and capital. طبعا الاثنين دول الفاكتورز ديت او الافيشنسي of using factors of production increased، ده بيعمل لي حاجة اسمها الإيكونوميك جروث، هيبقى عندي نمو اقتصاد. okay، this caused long run aggregate supply curve shift rightward from LRES node to LRES 1 to LRES 2. This rightward shift result in a permanent increase in the potential level of national income and a reduction in the price level. طبعا كل الشيفتس دي بتحصل في long run، takes long time. Our last point in this chapter about the paradox of thrifts. Thrifts means saving. Paradox, we can call it dilemma. ده معناه ايه؟ انا بقول what is the impact of saving. الايكونومست لاحظوا ان making saving has an impact in short run مختلف عن الامباكت بتاعه في long run. okay، طيب يبقى الـ paradox of thrifts في الأول خلص، ده معناه إيه؟ إن أنا عندي an increase in national saving. لو أنا قررنا في inside the economy إن national saving would increase، ده معناه إيه؟ معناها إن الـ consumption would decrease، والـ consumption ده component من الـ aggregate demand. okay، this in the short run this would affect aggregate demand negatively. Aggregate demand curve would shift leftward from aggregate demand node to aggregate demand 1, causing a reduction in real GDP or in the real level of national income. okay، ده تأثير increasing national saving in the short run. تمام، but in the long run the national saving ده هيحصل ايه؟ ده هيعمل ايه؟ هيتحول طبعا ل investment، وال investment ده يعني when the investment is accumulated ده بيكون حاجة اسمها capital formation inside the economy، وال capital formation would when capital formation increase this would affect the level of national income in the long run. ممكن نفكر فيها بطريقة تانية، إن السيفينج لما بيزيد هيأثر على الانفستمنت، والانفستمنت لما بيزيد through the multiplier the level of national income would increase. okay، graphically the long run aggregate supply curve would shift rightward. okay، causing a permanent increase in the level of GDP. okay، so it's better to save now in order to improve the welfare in the future. okay، because if we decrease saving in the short run real national income would decrease but the capital formation decreases in the long run. so the level of national income or the potential level of national income would decrease and we can call it economic deterioration. يبقى it's better for the economy to increase the national saving in the short run. لما باخد قرار ان الناشنال سيفينج should increase هيبقى ليه تأثير طبعا negative في الشورت ران، ان ال level of GDP or level of national income would be reduced but in the long run the increase in national saving would boost the economic growth through increasing the investment and investment affect the national income through the multiplier.